All right, let's now have a look at while loops together, which are arguably our most important loop we have in programming. So a while loop is an example of condition-controlled iteration. It's not our only example because we also have do-until loops we'll look at in the next video. But what is condition-controlled iteration? Well, this is where we have iteration that repeats based on a condition. A condition needs to be Boolean, it's either true or false, and we repeat either based on that condition being true or that condition being false. And in the case of a while loop, it runs if the condition is true. A do-until loop runs if the condition is false. So there are different ways of approaching this type of iteration. The reason why I said that arguably it's our most important type of loop is because we don't actually need for loops. Every for loop can get written as a while loop, but not every while loop can get written as a for loop. So here is the for loop I showed you at the start of the last video where we're just printing 1 to 5. Here's how I could rewrite it as a while loop. And you could be asked to do this in the exam. But most importantly, let's look at the syntax of this while loop. So we have while and end while, which start and end our loop. We should indent it. This is in OCR ERL. In Python, it's a little bit different. We don't have end while and we have a colon, but we should indent it even though it's not essential in OCR ERL. So these two lines are within our while loop. These are the two lines which would be running as it is iterating. Our condition follows the word while. This needs to be Boolean. So what it's saying is, as the word while suggests, while count is less than or equal to 5, we're going to run these two lines of code. And the whole point is that eventually this condition should become false. So eventually it should stop looping. So we know this code is going to print 1 to 5, but let's just trace through it a little bit just so we have a clear idea about how this is working. Initially count is set to 1 outside of my loop. My condition is checking to see if count is less than or equal to 5, which it is. 1 is less than or equal to 5. So therefore our loop code runs. We print count to the user, so the user sees 1 on their screen, and we add 1 to the old value of count and set that to be the new value of count. So count is now 2. We're going, is 2 less than or equal to 5? Yes, that's still true. So we run the code again, we print the new value of count, which is 2, and we add 1 to it. So now the 2 becomes a 3. This condition is still true. So we run the print line again. We print 3. Count now becomes 4. We go back up and check our condition. 4 is still less than or equal to 5. Therefore, I print 4. We then add 1 to count. So count is now 5. We go back up and check our condition. This happens after every iteration to see if it's still true. Well, 5 is still less than or equal to 5 because of this equal sign. Therefore, I print count again. And now count is equal to count plus 1. So count is now 6. But now 6 is not less than or equal to 5, therefore this is false, therefore our while loop ends. So do try and visualize in your head that it is going back on itself every time. It is checking our condition after every iteration to see if it eventually becomes false. Let's look at a couple of examples where we need to use a while loop and we can't use a for loop to solve this. So we're going to ask the user to enter their birth year. It must be between 1930 and 2020 to be valid. Keep asking until it is valid, then say thank you. Any question which says something like keep asking or ask until, this is a clear sign you need to use condition controlled iteration, either a while loop or do until. Let's ask the user first of all to enter their birth year. This line goes above our while loop because we need to use birth year in our condition. So we can go into our while loop now and write while. Now, the key thing here is to think about what is our condition. Remember, a while loop runs while our condition is true. And in what circumstance would I want it to run? Well, I only want my while loop to run if actually the user doesn't type in what they should be typing in. They should be typing in between 1930 to 2020. I only want the while loop to run if they don't type in that. Right, the while loop is there to keep asking until they do type it in. So my condition should really be while birth year is less than or equal to 1930, or birth year is greater than or equal to 2020. Now the word between usually implies that it's not inclusive unless it told you it was inclusive. So I'm assuming that 1930 and 2020 itself are not valid. And if I'm following OCR ERL strictly, which I don't have to do, of course, I should really do that as a capital or. Okay, now what should go inside my while loop? Well, I need to indent it first of all, so I need to leave a gap at the start. I need to keep asking until it is valid. So maybe let's tell them, first of all, this is invalid. What they typed in was invalid because it's outside of our valid range. But really, really importantly, you have to give the user a chance to get it right. I need to make sure I give the user another chance to input. almost always we have input in a while loop, you need to make sure you are not leaving it out. What I'm doing is literally copying my first input line inside the while loop. Okay, and then I need to end my while loop because I'm done. What's the last job to do here? Well, we have to say thank you when the user eventually gets it right. I can put this outside of my while loop because we will not ever reach this point unless the user has typed in a valid response. If the user keeps typing in invalid birth years, they will never reach this point. And this is why we can't use a for loop for this problem, because this loop might never run. It might run a million times. It might run a billion times. It might run seven times. We don't know ahead of time how many times it's going to run. A for loop needs to have a set number of repeats. You know, if I type in 2000 as a birth year, that is valid according to this question. Therefore, while loop gets completely skipped because the condition was false. The loop doesn't run at all. We just print thank you. However, let's say I get it wrong and I type in initially 1875. I'm very old. Well, the while loop condition is true because this left-hand side is true, and OR only needs one side to be true for the whole thing to be true. So if we print invalid, we therefore ask the user to enter their birth year again. Let's say I type in this time 1945. Well, it goes back round to check my condition, and now neither of these sides is true. 1945 isn't less than or equal to 1930 or greater than or equal to 2020. Therefore, this while loop condition is false. Therefore, it skips the rest of this while loop and goes back down to the last line where it says thank you. Just to emphasize something I was talking about regarding the input inside a while loop, it's really, really important your loop will eventually end. We don't want a situation where we have an infinite loop. With a for loop, we're never going to have an infinite loop where it will not end, because it's always a set number of times and that has to be a finite number. But because we're looping based on a condition, if our condition is never going to turn false, we're never going to end our loop, which is poor program design. It will close eventually because you can close your program, but it's just bad design. It may cause your program to freeze or crash eventually. So here is another question. We're going to ask the user to enter their favorite subject. If it is not equal to computer science, we're going to say wrong choice and ask them again. When it is eventually equaling computer science, we say great choice. So again, part of the skill is trying to pick apart what we need to use based on our question. It does start by saying if it is not equal to. So you might be tempted to use an if statement, but here we have to use a while loop because we're going to ask them again. And the word eventually implies that we're going to continually ask until they eventually type in computer science. So here is an example of where you might make a small mistake. Structurally, this code looks all right. If you do it on paper, you obviously can't tell this code is not going to work. However, this code has a bad error. If I run the code and get it wrong, so make my condition true by getting it wrong, if I type in maths, for example, I get wrong choice and it appears like forever. Now, in reality, it's not truly infinite because it will crash. Eventually, I will turn my computer off initially. I can just press stop. But that is what we call an infinite loop, where the condition never becomes false. It never becomes false because we get it wrong initially, then we just print wrong choice and it keeps going round. Keeps going round, checking our condition again. Our condition never becomes false because subject never gets reassigned. We need to reassign subject in our while loop to at least give it a chance to become false eventually. So the corrected code just has that variable assignment copied inside the while loop as well. So we're giving our user a chance to re-enter a value which does equal computer science. If they re-enter a value which does equal it, this condition then becomes false and the while loop will end. But unless I give the user a chance to change it, it will never end and it will become an infinite loop, which isn't good.